सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदोस्तां हमारा, ये तो हमें पता है, लेकिन हमारा इंडिया इतना महान क्यों है? देखना चाहते हैं इस वीडियो को देखिए, लेकिन उसके पहले चैनल को सब्सक्राइब तो कीजिए।
वी विल स्पीक टू द ऑडियंस अबाउट द वेस्टर्न एंड सेंट्रल पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया। वी विल बिगिन विद द वेस्टर्न पार्ट फर्स्ट, व्हिच इंक्लूड्स द स्टेट्स ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, राजस्थान एंड गुजरात। Let me begin by telling you all the information we found for the state of Maharashtra. Maharashtra is located on the western coast of the southern part of India. Look, here it is in the map. It is bound by the Arabian Sea to the west. The capital city of Maharashtra is Mumbai. Other important cities are Pune, Nagpur, Nashik, and Aurangabad. नर्मदा, तापी, गोदावरी, कृष्णा आदर रिवर्स विच फ्लो थ्रू द स्टेट। वी कैन फाइंड टीक, एकेशिया, शीशम, मैंगो एंड कोकोनट ट्रीज हियर। द मेजर क्रॉप्स ग्रोन इन द स्टेट आर शुगर केन, ऑयल सीड्स, ग्राउंडनट्स एंड राइस। फ्रूट्स लाइक बनाना, गुआवा, ग्रेप्स, ऑरेंजेस एंड कैश्यू आर ऑल्सो ग्रोन इन महाराष्ट्र। Great job, boys. I think we should speak to the audience in detail about Mumbai. After all, it is called the commercial capital of India. Did you know that it is also the most populous city in our country? Since it is so close to the coast, the climate is moderate. Mumbaikers or the people of Mumbai mostly speak in Hindi, Marathi or Konkani. I do not know about the languages, but the food in Mumbai is so delicious. Bhel puri, pani puri, pav bhaji, vada pav, wow! Not to forget all the sweets they prepare for the festivals, especially Ganesh Chaturthi.
When my family visited Mumbai last year, my father told me that Mumbai is the richest city in India. Moreover, most of our favorite film stars live and work in Mumbai. Dad said it is called the city that never sleeps. It must be true that Chhatrapati Maharaj Shivaji Terminus Railway Station and the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj International Airport are the busiest in all of our country.
Wow! What else did you see in Mumbai, Janvi?
You know how much I love ancient history and the stories behind each building or construction. My dad took me to the Gateway of India, which was built to mark the visit of the British monarch King George V to India. We also went to see the Elephanta Caves. They date back to the 5th century.
If I go to Mumbai, I'll definitely visit the beaches, Juhu and Chowpatty. I have heard they have amazing street food in the area.
So, it seems like our section on Maharashtra is almost complete. Guys, for the next section, I'd like to be the one to speak about my hometown, Rajasthan.
Yes, yes. Definitely.
Go ahead.
All of you must have heard of the Great Indian Desert.
Here it is in the book. Isn't that the Thar Desert, Manan?
Yes, Rebecca. The Thar Desert lies in the western part of Rajasthan. Due to this, the climate in my state is hot and dry. Even in Gujarat, our neighboring state, the land is dry in nature. The major rivers that flow through Rajasthan are Luni, Ghagar and Banas. You can easily find teak, acacia and bamboo trees here. We also grow plenty of barley, mustard, coriander, fenugreek, gaur and millet crops.
Manan, this book mentions the pink city of Rajasthan. What is that?
I missed that point entirely. The pink city is Jaipur, the capital of Rajasthan. Most of the buildings in the city are painted pink, giving the city its name. Another popular city that attracts a lot of tourists here is Udaipur, also called the City of Lakes.
Brilliant job, Manan. I did some research for the next state, Gujarat. Let me tell you about it.
Gujarat is located on the west coast of India. Its capital is Gandhinagar. Other major cities here are Ahmedabad, Surat, and Vadodara. Three major rivers of India flow through the state: Sabarmati, Tapi, and Narmada. Mainly crops like cotton, sugarcane, bajra, and maize are grown in Gujarat.
Hurrah! We are prepared with one half of our project.
In that case, all of you deserve a short break now. Here are some cookies, fresh from the oven.
Yay! Thank you, Sharma Uncle.
I was overhearing your discussion, and I think you have missed an important area of western part of our country. However, it isn't a state. Here, let me show you.
What is that area, Sharma Uncle?
Janvi dear, it is right on the border between Gujarat and Maharashtra. It is the union territory of Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. Does anyone know what the capital of this territory is?
I know, Daman, isn't it, Uncle? This was a question in our GK test last week.
Very good, Rebecca. River Daman Ganga flows through this union territory. The territory has trees like tortillas, hookah, acacia and casuarinas, and teak forests. People grow rice, ragi, millets, jowar, pulses, wheat, sugarcane and groundnut here, besides some vegetables and fruits.
Thank you for bringing this to our notice, Uncle.
You are welcome, Manan. I think it is time now to move to some of the central states in India, isn't it? Let me tell you about the state I come from, Madhya Pradesh. I was raised in the capital city, Bhopal, but I have also lived in other cities like Indore, Gwalior and Jabalpur. We have plenty of teak, sal and bamboo trees in our state. The major source of water in the state is from the rivers Betwa, Chambal, Son and Mahanadi. We grow plenty of crops in Madhya Pradesh, such as wheat, gram, mustard and soybean.
Wow, that's great, Sharma Uncle. I have noted some points for us to use. Let's take Chhattisgarh as our next section in the project. I know a bit about it. It is a neighboring state to Madhya Pradesh and is also centrally located in the country. Raipur is its capital. Other main cities are Chitrakoot, Bilaspur, Bhilai and Bastar. Rivers Mahanadi, Indravati and Godavari flow through the state. Yes, Harshit. And look, the book says the state has sal, bamboo and teak trees in large numbers. They also cultivate crops such as rice, wheat, groundnut, pulses and oil seeds. Even fruits like banana and guava are grown here.
Great! Let's move to the final portion of our project now, Jharkhand. It is a neighbor to Chhattisgarh and has Ranchi as its capital. Jamshedpur, Bokaro, Hazaribagh and Dhanbad are all major cities in the state. Rivers Subarnarekha and Kharkhai provide water to Jharkhand. A lot of Jharkhand's land is covered by forests. They have sal, mahua, palm, bamboo and banyan trees in large numbers. They also grow rice, millet, wheat, pulses, gram, mustard and maize crops.
And we are done. I think we are ready for the presentation now.
ये सोशल साइंस का वीडियो अगर आप लोगों को पसंद आया होगा तो लाइक कीजिए, शेयर कीजिए, सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और ऐसे ही देखते रहिए. धन्यवाद.